Round number one begins. Alexander Usyk of the Ukraine in the red is the reigning world champion. 25 years of age, he beat Artur Beterbiev of Russia in his first bout, 17-13. Tervel Pulev is from Bulgaria. He's 29. He beat Yamil Peralta of Argentina in his last bout, 13-10. Teddy, these two met at the World Championships in the round of 16. And Usyk was a winner.
Yeah, actually, they have fought twice before, and Usyk 2-0. So Usyk, one of the, you touched on it, one of the favorites to gold in this division, and has to be a big favorite going into this match, having beaten Pulev twice already.
In Pulev's first bout on August the 1st, he knocked down Wang Xuanquan of China twice in that bout, nearly knocked him out.
You know, both these fighters, Usyk and Pulev, were hurt to the body in this tournament. I wonder if they want to make a little silent agreement and don't go to each other's bodies, because both of them are susceptible there. But no agreement there by Usyk, throwing some left hands underneath. Usyk is a southpaw, and the orthodox fighter is Pulev. Looks like Usyk wants to be the boss, inching his way in, while Pulev trying to use lighter feet to move around, trying to navigate an advantage.
With Pulev winning at least a bronze in this weight class, the heavyweight class, which originated in 1984, he's the first boxer from Bulgaria to win a heavyweight medal. And this is the 18th boxing medal for Bulgaria, earned by Pulev. Usyk stepped in with a left and knocked down Pulev.
That's one way to be the boss.
5, 6, 7, 8.
The power punch for the southpaw Usyk, the left hand, the punch that he can turn his back into, do damage with.
End of round number one. Usyk with a 6-2 lead. Round number two begins between Alexander Usyk of the Ukraine in the red and Tervel Pulev of Bulgaria in the blue. Usyk with a left hand that dropped Pulev in the first round, and he landed another good left hand there. Usyk, quarterfinalist in Beijing, lost to Clemente Russo of Italy 7-4. And he's just punching. He wasn't going to allow Pulev to hold him.
Now, right now, this looks like a dog-cat fight. What I mean by that is the dog would be the fighter from the Ukraine. He's looking to eat Pulev. And Pulev's the cat. He's looking to scratch and claw and survive.
Good left hook that Usyk landed. Good uppercut by Usyk. Snap back the head of Pulev.
I think Usyk would help himself maybe score another knockdown possibly if he'd start going to the body of Pulev. I mean, the only thing that's keeping really Pulev in the fight is his legs. No better way to take those legs away than go downstairs.
Nice combination to the head scored by Usyk. Not much coming back from Pulev.
Now the dog is looking to have his meal.
Pulev stood right in front of Usyk and he threw that left hand again.
Again, the only thing I'd be a little perplexed about, there's not a lot to be perplexed about if you're in the corner of Usyk, but why is he not going to the body? The only thing that, again, is keeping Pulev in the fight is his legs. Take them away, go downstairs, then go back upstairs.
Heard you there with a hook to the body, and he goes right back up to the head.
We'll find out how good the corner is if Pulev gets to that corner. We'll see whether or not Usyk's corner tells him concentrate on that body, which I think they definitely should be telling him.
He's racking up a lot of points, though.
Yes, he is.
8-2 round for Usyk. Alexander Usyk of Ukraine with a 14-4 lead over Tervel Pulev of Bulgaria. He dropped him in the first round with a straight left hand. And he's pretty much controlled this bout. Usyk sticks a jab there that caught the forehead of Pulev. A little short with that left. He gets the occasional hook to the body from Usyk, Teddy.
Nothing consistent, you're right. Just a little bit in spots, but I'd be looking for the consistent effort, as I said earlier, because Pulev, the only thing he's doing is using those tires to wheel around the ring to survive, and you deflate tires by going, in boxing anyway, by going downstairs, taking air out.
There's a left and a right to the body from Usyk.
I honestly believe that Usyk could have scored one of those rare happenings in the Olympics, a knockout, if he had concentrated more on the body.
He's having a pretty easy time, though, with Pulev.
He's having fun right now. Very relaxed. You can see, just letting those punches go nice and loose. Not necessarily putting bad intentions behind them is Usyk right now.
Pulev not exactly ripping his shots either.
No, because he's been ripped. He's lost that desire to rip, or that confidence to rip punches. He's been broken down a little bit. Right now, you make a good point. The more I look at it, Pulev throwing don't hit me punches. Nice and carefully just placing them out there very politely, too politely.
Yeah, he's not firing back with anything. Not trying to land a haymaker or anything like that. Look, see, look, he's just tapping Usyk. And in turn, he gets smacked going back. Easy win for Alexander Usyk of Ukraine.
You're right, Bob. Doesn't get too much easier than that.
You see the work of Usyk.
Yeah, the dog will be howling tonight. Howling Goodwin. Some work there by Jusek. Good head movement by Jusek, even though it wasn't necessary, nothing was coming.
And you see the boxers on the Ukrainian team, they all have the very interesting haircuts.
Either that or very bad barbers.
I think the kids are trying to make a statement, Teddy.
Okay, I'll buy into it.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner by score of 21 points to 5 in the red corner, representing Ukraine, Oleksandr Jusek.
Oleksandr Jusek of Ukraine, easy win. He's on his way to Saturday's gold medal bout in the heavyweight division.